I am Tuhin Mukherjee, a mechanical engineering faculty at Iowa State University. The properties and performance of metallic parts made by additive manufacturing depend on grain structure, phases, and defects. Printing parameters such as temperature, cooling rates, and material composition can influence grain size and orientation, impacting mechanical properties. Avoiding unwanted transformations ensures the desired microstructure. Managing defects like pores and cracks demands optimized printing paths and energy settings. Several of my distinguished colleagues, Dr. John Elmer of Lawrence Livermore National Lab, Professor Huliang Wei of Nanjing University of Science and Technology, Dr. Thomas Lienert of Optomec and T.J. Lienert Consulting LLC, Professor Wei Zhang of Ohio State University, Professor Sindo Ku of the University of Wisconsin, Professor Tarshankar DebRoy of Pennsylvania State University, and I tried to create a roadmap to control microstructures of additively manufactured parts in a recent paper that I want to introduce to you in this video. First, I want to tell you about the content of the paper. Most importantly, we provide a compilation of reusable insights that often elude us in isolated studies on grain structure, phases, and defects in printed parts. We also provide alloy-specific microstructure control strategies. This is key to unlocking the full potential of additive manufacturing for each alloy. Our paper examines the important roles played by mechanistic modeling and machine learning in controlling the microstructures of printed metallic parts. We show how these cutting-edge technologies are shaping the future of additive manufacturing. We identify gaps in knowledge and research needs in the area of controlling the microstructure of printed metallic parts. This section will help identify important areas of research and collaboration. Finally, we provide an outlook into the future based on evidence. What can we expect in the ever-evolving world of additive manufacturing, particularly in the context of grain structure, phases, and defects? Thank you, and let's begin our exploration of the contents. In this review paper, we provide alloy-specific control strategies for grain structure, phases, and defects in printed parts. We focus on most of the major alloy groups such as steels, nickel alloys, titanium alloys, aluminum alloys, copper alloys, and compositionally graded alloys. This slide gives several examples of alloy classes that are covered. After an alloy solidifies and cools below its solidest temperature, it undergoes phase transformations along the way. The transformations during cooling result in a wide variety of primary and secondary phases with diverse crystal structures and chemical compositions. These phases include carbides, nitrides, oxides, and precipitates, and they significantly affect the microstructure and mechanical properties of parts. Grain structure affects the properties and serviceability of additively manufactured metallic parts. Solidification morphology and grain size are the two most important attributes of grain structure. Long columnar grains degrade the tensile properties and also can promote solidification cracking. Grain structure is significantly affected by the temperature gradient during solidification and solidification growth rate. Both these parameters can be calculated using a heat transfer and fluid flow model. Grain structure can be columnar or equiaxed depending on the values of these parameters and the alloy. Grain structures of titanium alloys can be controlled by adjusting the morphology by varying process parameters. For example, the addition of boron can refine grains. As the picture shows, a supercooled region formed around the beta-stabilizing elements such as tungsten, niobium, and molybdenum due to their dissolution, causing the particles to act as sites for homogeneous nucleation and subsequent growth of fine grains. New alloys are also being designed to achieve the desired grain structure. Finally, post-process heat treatment can be used to optimize the grain structure. One of the key challenges in additive manufacturing is the control of the phases that form during additive manufacturing. The phases influence mechanical properties such as strength, ductility, and hardness. For a given alloy, the phases that form depend on processing parameters such as heat source power, speed, and layer thickness. The cooling rates play an important role in determining the phase transformations and the final phase compositions. Phase transformations during cooling result in a wide variety of primary and secondary phases with diverse crystal structures and chemical compositions. Post-processing heat treatments can be employed to further refine the phase compositions of additively manufactured metallic parts. The future of controlling phases and microstructure in additive manufacturing is closely tied to mechanistic modeling and machine learning. simulations can predict some of the microstructural features based on process parameters and material properties. By using these tools, engineers and researchers can reduce the number of trial and error tests to achieve a desired microstructure. Here we show the phases in an oxide dispersion strengthened, ODS, steels that contain nano-sized oxides. They have excellent thermal stability and they are uniformly dispersed in the iron-based alloy matrix. This figure shows nano-sized oxides of aluminum and yttrium in a part made by laser powder bed fusion. Oxides of titanium, iron, and chromium are also common. These steels have excellent strength and high temperature creep strength owing to the dispersion strengthening of the oxide particles as well as the solid solution strengthening of the iron-based alloy matrix. The methods used to control phases in parts are highly alloy dependent and these are discussed in the review. Defects are a very important feature of microstructure. There are a variety of common defects in additive manufacturing shown in this display. They all affect the properties and serviceability of components. The control strategies vary depending on the type of defects, the alloy, and the specific additive manufacturing process. For example, cracking may be prevented in some cases by changing the grain morphology from columnar to equiaxed grains. The paper explains several ways to do that. Similarly, the paper discusses how other defects shown here can be controlled. We give one example in the next slide of how common defects in titanium alloys can be controlled. Common defects in the additive manufacturing of titanium alloys include porosity, lack of fusion, and selective vaporization of aluminum resulting in composition change. As shown in the display, post-process hot isostatic pressing can reduce the volume fraction of small pores. The lack of fusion pores that are typically larger than the gas porosity can be controlled often by increasing heat source power or reducing scanning speed. Adjusting process parameters such as heat input can reduce peak temperature and evaporative loss, and limit composition change resulting from vaporization. Specific control strategies for a variety of defects in many alloys are discussed in this review. Our survey of previous research has identified important opportunities for research and collaboration. Here we note several such opportunities. In additive manufacturing, there are many process variables and they vary considerably depending on the specific additive manufacturing process and alloy. Because of this large parameter space, work is needed to improve our understanding of the relationships between processing, microstructure, properties, and performance. The microstructure of most alloys contains various special features. This paper shows how understanding the hierarchical microstructures and other special features is vital for achieving improved part properties. Controlling solidification morphology is essential for additive manufacturing. Achieving equiaxed grains, for example, remains challenging and needs further research. Defects, such as lack of fusion voids, surface roughness, and distortions, can significantly impact mechanical properties. Understanding their evolution and influence on properties is very important. Developing a database that catalogs alloy susceptibilities to defects and undesirable microstructures can help engineers select appropriate combinations of printing processes and alloys, avoiding costly trial and error. Additive manufacturing integrates digital technology, and mechanistic models and machine learning algorithms can predict and control microstructural features. These tools are valuable for optimizing process variables and product attributes, especially in cases where a clear mechanistic understanding is lacking. In summary, further research is needed in several areas to advance microstructure control in additive manufacturing to maximize its potential in various industries. Several trends are clear from the recent progress in controlling the microstructure of printed metal parts. First, ongoing work on a better understanding of correlations between process parameters, microstructural features, and properties will contribute to a printability database. This database will be very valuable for printing sound components. Second, additively manufactured parts of some alloys have successfully overcome the strength-ductility trade-off. As mechanisms are further studied, it's expected to yield enhanced part properties and serviceability. Third, conventional alloys used in additive manufacturing weren't specifically designed for it. Multiple thermal cycles in AM affect microstructure and properties. While process models are emerging, correlating process variables with microstructure will continue. New alloys and functionally graded materials will continue to be developed for AM. Also, additively manufactured parts often have defects that affect properties and serviceability. Post-processing techniques help, but they increase the cost of parts. Mechanistic modeling and machine learning offer a promising path to control defects and enhance serviceability. Finally, when we combine mechanistic models with experimental data, we get a solid scientific foundation for selecting the right process parameters. This will significantly reduce the need for time-consuming trial and error processes and ensure that we get it right from the get-go. Machine learning's role in MM will undoubtedly expand, particularly in controlling microstructure and properties. More details on the control of microstructure can be found in the review paper, Control of Grain Structure, Phases, and Defects in Additive Manufacturing of High-Performance Metallic Components. The paper can be downloaded from the Progress in Materials Science Journal's website or obtained by writing to the authors. The link to access the paper from the publisher's website can be found in the description of this video.